how you feel, Cam? Sheesh. NFL signs 3 more guys from the XFL? The NFL did what to the playoff system? Wow, a lot of crazy news. I gotta fill you in on the latest. You already know, drop the intro. What it do, YouTube? It's your boy Dove here again. Your boy Dove knows sports. And I appreciate you checking out my channel again. I'll be giving you the latest update with NFL free agency. More XFL guys signed this week. The who's the top NFL free agents that's left out there. Also, what happened to the NFL playoff system. Some interesting and surprising news happened this week. Check it out. Let's get right into it. 3 more XFL guys just signed to NFL teams in this free agency. Starting with Houston Roughnecks cornerback Deatrick Nichols signs a 1-year deal with the New Orleans Saints. He was the XFL leader with interceptions with 3. This is going to be a great defensive back that the Saints can add to their room. I'm interested to see how his role will play out with the Saints, to see if they're actually going to give these XFL guys a chance to get reps to actually play this season. So he was the first one to sign. New York Guardians safety Dravon Askew-Henry signs a 2-year deal with the New York Giants. He's a former West Virginia Mountaineer. The Giants, man, they could use anybody in that secondary at this point to help them out on defense. So let's see how he works out at the next level. I've seen he's a versatile guy. He can play different positions within the secondary. So let's see how that transitions to the NFL from the XFL. The DC defender tight end Khari signs a 1-year deal with the Atlanta Falcons. As you know, the Falcons, they traded off their tight end Austin Hooper at the beginning of this free agency, leaving a void at the tight end position. Hopefully, Lee can come in and give Atlanta Falcons the same spark that he was able to bring to the DC defenders this past season. He was with 4 NFL teams before he joined the XFL, and now he has another opportunity to get a real deal and a real shot in the NFL. So let's see how things play out for him moving forward this season. Some of the top free agents that's left on the market. As the market died down, the top big free agents are getting smaller and smaller. So let's see who's still left available on the market. Former Tampa Bay Bucks quarterback Jameis Winston, also former Carolina Panthers quarterback Cam Newton, are both still available in free agency. Some of the best teams that's left for these two quarterbacks to sign that need quarterbacks are the LA Chargers, the Jacksonville Jaguars, the Miami Dolphins, the Denver Broncos, the New England Patriots, and the Washington Redskins, just to name a few teams that can still fill that quarterback room with some good number one overall draft picks. Which team do you think these guys will sign to? And how do you feel that they're being treated, as both of these guys are 2 former number one overall picks in NFL draft in recent, and they're still being held out as far as signing with an NFL franchise. Jadeveon Clowney is still on the market, and one of the reasons why, because his asking prices are too high for what NFL teams are willing to pay for the pass rush. He initially asked between $20 to $18 million per season entering this year's free agency. There was no takers on that price. Now there's reports that he's willing to sign for less, and the only team that I have reported reached out to him are the Tennessee Titans. So let's see in the next coming days how things will play out now that he's willing to take less money. In other NFL news, the NFL has approved the playoff expansion for the 2021 season. The league will now go from 12 teams to 14 playoff teams. It will be an extra team in each conference that will be added into the playoffs. Now both conferences will have 7 teams per conference entering into playoffs. The only adjustment now is that the top seed will only get a bye week. How the format is set now, the top 2 seeds get a bye week. Now with the rule change, only the top seed will get a bye week and everybody else will have to play. The league is also still looking to expand the season from 16-game regular season to 17-game after the 2020 season as well. From an NFL fan standpoint, it's great, man. You got more football, and what else could you ask for than more NFL? But from a player standpoint, there's definitely concerns as far as injury for playing such a long season and then having extended playoffs. I'm curious to see how things play out moving forward from the NFL owners versus the players when it comes to extending the season. So far from what I heard, there's a lot of backlash as far as extending the season an extra game. But let's see how things play out in the upcoming season as far as the NFL owners versus the players moving forward. And that's the latest news that I have for you. I appreciate you checking out my video and staying in tune with me. I'm gonna continue to give you these updates each and every week. I appreciate you checking out my video. And again, you already know it's your boy Dove, and your boy Dove knows sports, and I'm out.